Assalamu alaikum. Hope so you people are doing well. So today we are going to discuss about cardiotocography and how to interpret cardiotocography. Cardiotocography is also known as CTG. And so as you guys can see that I have marked these three things, that cardio means heart, toco means contractions of the uterus, and graphy is the recording. So it's really simple that it is the recording of the fetus or fetal heart and contractions of the uterus. It is usually done during the third trimester, and which is about 27 weeks till the end of the pregnancy, and it is a non-invasive procedure, so it's safe for the mother as well as the fetus. So what is basically the purpose of doing this cardiotocography or CTG? It is to record fetal heart sound so that we can do the see the uterine activity and fetal distress. So how to interpret the CTG? It's really simple. Just memorize this formula, which is Dr. C. Bravado, and each word stands for something. For example, doctor stands for defined risk, contractions, C for contractions, BR for baseline heart rate, then A for acceleration, VA for variability, D for deceleration, and O for overall impression. So number one was defined risk. So the risk can be high risk or low risk. So now we have to indicate that the mother that came for the CTG, or you have to do the CTG, is high risk or low risk. So what are the indications for high risk pregnancy? It includes gestational diabetes, hypertension, maternal age less than 16 or greater than 35, preeclampsia, intrauterine growth restriction, post-term pregnancy, multiple gestation, history of preterm labor, if there is premature rupture of membranes, meconium stained liquor. So these are the indications for high risk pregnancy. At first I just wanted to explain you this diagram, that this is the strip of CTG. You guys can see there is upper box and there is a lower box. So this upper box is for the fetus, which is fetal heart rate, and the lower is for the uterus, mainly the uterine contractions are present in the lower box. So okay, now number second point was the contractions. Number second point was the contraction. So we are now going to learn about the contractions. So contractions are going to be normal if less than 5 in 10 minutes, and they would be high if greater than 5 in 10 minutes. Okay, so just memorize these things so that we can interpret this on a proper CTG. Then baseline heart rate normal is between 110 to 160 beats per minute. Then acceleration is greater than or equal to 15 beats per minute for greater than or equal to 15 seconds. Then variability is 5 to 25 beats per minute, and deceleration is greater than or equal to 15 beats per minute for greater than or equal to 15 seconds. So now we are going to explain baseline rate. Heart rate was 110 to 160 beats per minute. So contractions. So what are contractions? Number second point is contractions. So just look at this diagram. Now these three are different types of contractions. So why to see uterine contractions? So it is basically to see if the mother is in labor or not. Sometimes no contractions are there, so it is completely okay to not to have any contractions, because initially the contractions are less frequent, but as the pregnancy progresses, this intensity gradually increases, so contractions also increases. So this one is without contractions. There are a lot of contractions and there are less contractions. Baseline heart rate is normal is 110 to 160 beats per minute. Now what is acceleration? Right, number fourth was acceleration. So acceleration, as I have discussed earlier, that greater than or equal to 15 beats per minute for greater than or equal to 15 seconds. This means that there should be, for example, if this is the acceleration, then if this is the acceleration, then it should rise for 15 beats per minute for 15 seconds. Okay, so It should rise for 15 beats per minute and it should persist for 15 seconds. Then is the variability. So what basically is variability? Variability is, the normal variability is between 5 to 25 beats per minute. But what actually is variability? It is actually the fluctuations in the baseline fetal heart rate that are irregular in amplitude and frequency, but you just have to omit exclude the accelerations and decelerations. So here in this diagram you guys can see that these can be variability, but it should be for 10 minutes and you have to exclude these accelerations. So by or decelerations, if there would be deceleration, then just exclude those things and that would be your variability, and it should be for 10 minute window period. And number sixth one is the deceleration. It's the same as acceleration, but let me discuss this in detail. As decelerations are usually not a good sign for the pregnancy. So decelerations are of three types, and they could be number one is early deceleration, number two is late deceleration, and number three is variable. So why do we get early deceleration? So this often happens during the early, as I've written that early decelerations are going to be due to head compression. So what actually is head compression? This often happens during later stages of labor as a baby is descending through the birth canal. They may also occur during early labor if the baby is premature or in a breech position. So this causes the uterus to squeeze the head during contractions. So the early decelerations can be like, you know, due to normal pregnancy as during the later stages, but it can also be a sign of not a good pregnancy. Okay, so number second one is late decelerations. It is due to poor placental perfusion, and number third is due to head compression as well as a cord compression. So now let us discuss this via different diagrams. So as you guys can see the different graphs. So now how you will like confirm that the TTD that you are seeing is early, having early deceleration, late or variable? So number one, we are going to discuss early. As you guys can see that fetal heart rate and contractions, we are going to compare these two. So as you guys can see that these are like the fetal heart rate are in aligning with the contractions. So you would say that this is early decelerations. Okay, but if there is a contraction, but after this contraction there is a fetal heart rate, so they are not aligning. That is that contractions are at are first, then is the fetal heart rate. So this means that the fetal heart rate are late. They are like late, that there is first there is a contraction, then there is a fetal heart rate deceleration. So you would say that this is late deceleration. And now the variable deceleration. The variable in variable deceleration, there is like no proper alignment. Like just see this fetal heart rate and these contractions are like not in a proper alignment. They are like just variable. They are random. So that would be variable. And the variable deceleration are the worst ones. They are the most dangerous one, because you have to take precautions or you just have to deliver the baby. Okay, so number seventh is overall impression. So now like for example, if there is a doctor and she asks you to comment on the CTG, so you have to comment, like, you know, you have to make your overall impression. So what will be your impression? So we at first I just want to make sure that you guys should know about reassuring, non-reassuring. So reassuring means that everything is normal. So normal baseline heart rate was 110 to 160 beats per minute. Variability was 5 to 25 beats per minute. Accelerations were normal, were two or more accelerations in 20 minute CTG strip, and there should be no decelerations. If these four things are there, then you are going to say that the CDG's trip is reassuring. But if you are going to see baseline heart rate 100 to 109, then that would be bradycardia. 161 to 180, that would be tachycardia. If variability is less than 5 beats per minute for 40 to 90 minutes, and there is no acceleration and there are variable decelerations, as I have discussed earlier, there are a lot of variable decelerations for 90 minutes, then that strip would be non-reassuring. And number third one is the abnormal. I will just zoom this here. Okay, so number third one is abnormal. If the baseline heart rate is less than 100 or greater than 180 and there is sinusoidal pattern, so baseline heart rate, if it is like this sinusoidal pattern and greater than and equal to 10 minutes, then that would be an abnormal feature. If variability is less than 5 for 90 minutes, if there are atypical variable decelerations with over 50% of contractions, and it's like that, this abnormal in the abnormal feature of decelerations, there would be like atypical variable decelerations, whereas in non-reassuring there would be variable decelerations. So, and accelerations are not present in non-reassuring or abnormal. So that would be non-reassuring or abnormal if decelerations are present. Okay, so now how we are going to comment this? So my overall impression would be, I am going to categorize that either it is normal, suspicious or pathological. So normal would be that all the features are reassuring, then I would say that it's normal and I don't have to take any sort of action at that time. Okay, so what is going to be suspicious? Suspicious is one non-reassuring feature. Like any one non-reassuring feature is there, then you have to take conservative measures. Okay, but and pathological would be that there are two non-reassuring features or one abnormal feature, as I have discussed the abnormal features as well. So the action would be that you are going to do the fetal scalp sampling, or you just have to deliver the baby because it's now pathological strip. So you just have to deliver the baby or do the fetal scalp sampling. So now we are going to study all these features on a proper CTG strip. So as I have write down the formula, Dr. C. Brevedo, so that would make easy that I have to mark all these things. So number one feature is doctor, which means define risk. So for example, if the patient is a diabetic one, so you would say that this is a CTG strip of a high risk patient. So now contractions. So as you guys can see that contractions should be of a 10 minute strip. So at first I just want to discuss that the small one vertical box is equal to 5 beats per minute, and the horizontal small box is equal to 30 seconds. Okay, so just do memorize this. So for example, so we are going to now mark this on the CTG strip. I have defined the risk. Now a contraction, so this lower one is the column or the box for the contraction. So this from here till here, this is a 10 minute CTG strip. So how many contractions can you count? This is number one contraction, this is another one, this is another one, this is another. So there are total 4 contractions. So we said that less than 5 contractions for 10 minutes, then that would be normal contractions. Okay, number third one is baseline heart rate. So now how to measure the baseline heart rate? Just see that, just randomly mark the line that mostly is persisting. So what almost this is. This one is 120 and this is 140. So it's between 120 and 140. As I've discussed that the one vertical box was 5 beats per minute. So 120, 125, just let me zoom this so that, okay. So just see this. This is 120, 125, 130, 135. So baseline heart rate of this baby or fetus is 135 beats per minute. Okay. Okay. Then what is the acceleration? So let me erase this. Okay, so where is the acceleration? Are these the accelerations? Are these the accelerations? Like everything is going, like baseline heart rate was this, and the lines which are going like up are the accelerations, and the ones with downward descent or the troughs are the decelerations. So now wish to consider accelerations and variability or decelerations. So it's very easy that as I have discussed that accelerations are going to be that which rises for about 15 beats per minute and persists for 15 seconds. So I think these are not the acceleration. So for example, I'm going to consider this one. So let me zoom this. Okay, so just see, it's really easy. Just mark from here till here and now just see and count. For example, I'm going to, like, I think this is the area. Okay, so this is 1 box 2 box 3 box 5 box and 5 box. So 1 2 3 4 and 5. Now just count 5 10 15 20 and 25. So it is 25 beats per minute, which is greater than 15. So that would be okay. Now I just have to see that is it persisting for 15 or more seconds. So now count from horizontal, like from here till here. So this is almost 1 box and 1/2 box, like just consider these two half boxes. So and 1 box was of 30 seconds, 1 small box was 30 seconds. So as I'm considering this a half box, then 15 and 15, this means 30 seconds. So it is greater than 15. So it is greater than 15 seconds. So which is 30 seconds. So it means that it is persisting more than 15 beats per minute, 15 seconds, and it is rising for 15 beats per minute, more than 15 beats per minute. So this, I would say that yes, there are accelerations, and there are more than 2 accelerations. So yes, this is a normal, right now, this is a normal and a good CTG. These are all signs of good CTG. Okay, so let me zoom out. Okay, so we have done the accelerations. Now the variability. So as I have discussed that the variability is going to be for 10 minutes. Just so now, for example, if I just, let me, okay. So for example, if I take this CTG strip, like I'm just omitting these accelerations and these accelerations, just consider this strip. So this would be the variability. So it should persist for like 5 to 25 beats per minute is considered a good variability, right? So like there are variability. So just consider this one. This is 1 box which is of 5. So yes, this is a variability, and there are 2 boxes included in these ones. So yes, 10 beats per minute. So it's between the range of 5 to 25. Yes. So, and these are actually the fluctuations excluding the accelerations and deceleration. So yes, variability is also present. So number second last is deceleration. Here in this strip, you guys cannot see any decelerations. So just to show you guys that if there was a deceleration, then how would be the CTG strip look like. So I have discussed this earlier. different types of deceleration. So just see this strip, like this is another strip. So just see that, for example, if this is the fetal heart rate, which is 120 beats per minute, and it's between the normal range, but these are the descending ones, right? These are the descending ones, the troughs. So is it deceleration or not? Just we are going to go according to our formula of that it should be falling for 15 beats per minute and persisting for 15 or more than 15 seconds. So 1 box, 2 box, 3 box, 4 box, 1, 2, 3 and 4 box. So 1 box was 5, 10, 15 and 20. So this is 20 beats per minute. And is it persisting for more than 15 seconds? Let's see that this one is almost the almost quarter, or you guys can consider this is a half box and almost a full box. So 30 plus 15 is 45 seconds. So yes, it is more than 15 seconds. So yes, I would say that yes, these are the decelerations. So now, which type of decelerations are these? So now let's see. Okay, so just see the contractions, that these are the contractions and these are the contractions. So at first there is a contraction and then there is a deceleration. So this means that these are the late decelerations. So and the late deceleration was due to the that we knew that this was due to the hypoxic conditions, the insufficiency of the placenta. So yes, so this is going to be a bad CTG. It's not a good CTG. So okay, so this was all about the CTG. Hopes you guys have understood this interpretation of CTG, and if you guys have understood, then do subscribe, comment, like and share. Jazakallah khair and Allah Hafiz.